Hello everyone, welcome to our channel. So this class is the continuation of the anatomy practical exam preparation. So in the last class we have seen the pharynx, and this class is the anatomy practical preparation of the larynx. So those who have not subscribed to the channel, subscribe now so that you will receive the gross anatomy lectures, histology, embryology, and also these practical exam preparations, which will help you a lot in the university exams, mainly for the practicals. So those who are not subscribed can subscribe now, and you can press the notification so that you will receive the everyday updates. Now we will continue with the larynx. When this larynx is given in the exam, mainly you have to discuss about the interior of the larynx in the practicals. So even though the cartilages and muscles, if you are knowing, first start discussing the interior of the larynx or the cavity of the larynx. So this larynx, if you see, it is extends from the upper border of the epiglottis. So this is the upper border of the epiglottis to the lower border of the cricoid cartilage. Above, it communicates with the laryngopharynx. So this is the laryngopharynx. This section is along with the tongue and pharynx. So this is the pharynx, which is cut open. Larynx is also open, but just made close together so that to show you the laryngeal inlet. So this larynx communicates with the laryngopharynx. So this is the laryngopharynx, which will continue as the esophagus. And this is the larynx, which will continue as the trachea. So larynx continue with the laryngopharynx through the laryngeal inlet above and below with the trachea. It lies opposite to the C6 vertebra in the adults and C1 to C4 vertebra in the children. So that is the extent of the larynx. You see the measurements vertically, it measures about 4.4 centimeter in the males and 3.6 centimeter in the females. You see the skeleton of the larynx, it is made of 9 cartilages, which are connected with one another by ligaments, joints, some synovial joints, intrinsic muscles, cricovocal and quadrate membranes. So these two membranes are important, you should remember, and lined internally by the mucous membrane. Out of the 9 cartilages, 3 are unpaired and 3 are paired. Unpaired cartilages include epiglottis, thyroid, so this is the thyroid which will be present only in the front, and this is the cricoid, which will be presenting anteriorly as arch and posteriorly as the lamina. So these are the cartilages, details of the cartilages, and we will not see the cartilages, synovial joints and the ligaments and the intrinsic muscles in the class. In this class, mainly we will see the interior of the larynx. So this laryngeal inlet boundaries we will see above by the upper border of the epiglottis. So this is the upper border of the epiglottis. Below and behind by the interarytenoid fold. So if you palpate here, you will see the small cartilages, arytenoid cartilages. Connecting them will be the interarytenoid fold. On each side by the aryepiglottic fold. So this connecting epiglottis and arytenoid. So what is this fold? Aryepiglottic fold. So this is the laryngeal inlet. On each side of the laryngeal inlet, in the lateral wall of the laryngopharynx, what is this? A deep recess, mucus covered deep recess, is called as the piriform fossa, which we have not shown you in the last class of the pharynx, because in the sagittal section of the head and neck, piriform fossa is difficult to show you. So here you can observe the piriform fossa. What are the boundaries of the piriform fossa? Medially, what is this fold? Now only we told, aryepiglottic fold. Laterally, mucous membrane covering the medial surface of the lamina of the thyroid cartilage. And here is the internal laryngeal nerve and superior laryngeal artery are related to this thyroid membrane in this just on the other side of the piriform fossa. So this is the sagittal section of the head and neck. In the last class of the pharynx, we have shown you. So So this is the nasopharynx, this is the oropharynx, and this is the laryngopharynx, which communicates with the larynx here through the laryngeal inlet. But on the lateral wall of the laryngeal, on the lateral wall of the laryngopharynx, piriform fossa we are not able to show you in the pharynx class. So that is shown in this class, larynx. So this is the larynx. You can observe nicely mucus covered deep recess, which is separated from the valicula. So this is valicula. Do you know what is valicula? You should have learnt in the tongue class, gross anatomy of tongue. So you know the tongue, and this is epiglottis. You should know the embryological relation of the tongue and epiglottis also. Both the posterior one third of the tongue and epiglottis develop from the hypobranchial eminence. So that's why they are connected with the connected together. This is epiglottis and tongue connected by three folds: median glossoepiglottic fold and lateral glossoepiglottic folds. So the depression between these three folds is called as the valicula. So this is one valicula and this is one valicula of the tongue. So this piriform fossa is separated from the valicula by the, this is the pharyngoepiglottic fold. So it is separated from the valicula. So what is the importance of this piriform fossa? It is more prominent in the animals than in the humans. The animals, you should have seen, they will take the food. Then after some time, they will bring the food to the, again to the mouth, and they will chew it. So that process is by this piriform fossa. There is more prominent in the animals. In the humans, it may be the point for the foreign body. Some foreign body, usually fish bones and all, they go and stuck here. So if we, the clinicians, want to remove the fish bones in this place or any foreign body, they should be careful of the internal laryngeal nerve and superior laryngeal artery related to the piriform fossa. This fossa is used by the smugglers sometimes to hide the precious objects, then bring back to the mouth. So these are the important features of the piriform fossa we have learned. Now we will move on to the interior of the larynx. So interior of the larynx, you can observe from the upper border of the epiglottis to the lower border of the cricoid cartilage. So this is the only one cricoid cartilage, which is the foundation stone of the larynx, which will be in front and behind also, like a signet ring. Other cartilages will be only front or partially. So this epiglottis, you can see thyroid will be acting like a shield like in front of the larynx. Only this cricoid, you can see this is the broader posterior lamina which is cut open. So this lower border of the cricoid cartilage. So this cavity of the larynx presents three parts. Three parts. If you see, three folds and three parts. What are three folds? First we will see, then we will move on to the three parts. So these are the three folds. This fold already we have seen. What is this fold? Aryepiglottic fold. And this is the another fold. First fold in the cavity of the larynx, are you seeing? That fold is the vestibular fold. So this is the vestibular fold. And there is another fold next to that will be called as the vocal fold. So what is this vestibular fold and what is this vocal fold? For that, you should know the two intrinsic ligaments here. You see, this is the mucous membrane. Just dissect the mucous membrane, then you will see one ligament, intrinsic ligament here and here. So that ligament or the, so here will be the quadrate membrane and here will be the cricovocal membrane. So the lower border of the quadrate membrane is thickened. That will be called as the vestibular ligament. When it is covered by mucous membrane, it is called as vestibular fold. If you see, this is the cricovocal membrane. Upper border of the cricovocal membrane is thickened, so that will be called as vocal ligament. When it is covered by mucous membrane, it will be called as the vocal folds. So these are the three folds we have learned. So the space between this vestibular folds will be the rima vestibuli. The space between the narrow gap between the vocal folds and the vocal process of arrest. If you close this, then that will be the shape of the rima glottis. So that between the vocal folds and vocal process of the arytenoid cartilages will be called as the rima glottis. So these are the three folds and the two spaces we have learned. Now subdivisions of the interior of the larynx. So this is the one subdivision above the vocal, above the vestibular fold. So that is the vestibule or the upper part. Then between the vestibule and the vocal folds, that is the second part. Below the vocal folds, that is the third part. So above the vestibular folds, if you see, this part will be called as the vestibule or the upper part. It extends from the aryepiglottic to the vestibular folds, and it is like a funnel, as if because the anterior wall of the larynx is more than the posterior wall. So this part is like a funnel from above downward and medially. So then between the, this is the intermediate part, sinus of larynx or intermediate part. It intervenes between the vestibular and the vocal folds. So it intervenes between the vestibular and vocal folds and presents on each side a mucus covered recess, deep recess, which extends laterally. So you have to hear. So this is the sinus of the larynx, which extends laterally into the lamina of the thyroid cartilage. So here what two membranes are not present? What are the two membranes? Cricovocal and the chordate membranes are not present. So this mucus lining has bulged laterally and it is filled with mucus glands, which secretions will help to lubricate the rima glottidis. So that is the function of the rima glottidis, that is the function of the saccule of the larynx. So this deep recess will be called as saccule. So this is vestibule. This part in between the two folds will be sinus, which is extending laterally, will be called as saccule. Below this, this part will be called as the infraglottic part or the lower part, which extends below the vocal folds, resembles like a truncated cone. So we have covered three folds, three parts of the cavity of the larynx. If you have completed these three parts of the cavity of the larynx, you may be asked, what is the nerve supply, sensory supply of the larynx? Above the vocal folds, internal laryngeal nerve. Below the vocal folds, recurrent laryngeal nerve. And what is the motor nerve of the larynx? All the intrinsic muscles of the larynx are supplied by the recurrent laryngeal nerve, except cricothyroid, which is supplied by the external laryngeal nerve. So like this, the cavity of the larynx will be mainly asked in the practical exams. And if at all, if you have completed the cavity of the larynx, you may be asked about the names of the intrinsic muscles, nerve supply and blood supply of the larynx. So you have to mainly concentrate on the interior of the larynx or the cavity of the larynx in the practical exams. So this class, I think, should help you a lot in this understanding the cavity of the larynx, which is a difficult part in the practicals in the head and neck region, is the pharynx and larynx. So keep watching this practical exams preparation so that it will be helping you in the university exam. Those who are not subscribed to the channel, subscribe now so that you will receive the everyday updates. We will see in the next class.